As much as I loved my grandmother, I never did like her honey cake. There, I've said it, it's out in the open. So this year for the Jewish holidays, I've created a new version using olive oil, red wine, and plenty of spices. This honey cake also happens to be incredibly easy to make. So I've got 3 eggs, I'm just whisking them up in a bowl, and now I'm gonna add all my liquid ingredients. Of course, I've got my honey. I've got really flavorful honey here from the farmer's market. I mean, if you just use regular supermarket honey, the cake will be good. But if you use amazing honey, it's gonna be even better. And then this is olive oil. Normally you would just use vegetable oil in a honey cake, but olive oil adds a slightly fruity floral flavor, which I really like. And then I have some red wine. You wanna use a pretty full-bodied red wine because you really wanna taste it here. So I'm just warning you, this is gonna be ugly. This is gonna look purple and unappetizing, but when it bakes up, it's just gonna look like honey cake, so don't worry. Then I have some grated fresh ginger root here. Most honey cakes use orange zest as a flavoring, and I thought I would just change it up a little bit. I almost forgot the sugar. And then for my dry ingredients, I have flour, a little bit of salt, baking powder, baking soda, and then I have cinnamon, ground ginger, and some cardamom. If you have old cardamom that's been sitting around your cabinets for a really long time, the Jewish holidays are the perfect excuse to buy new fresh cardamom. That is one spice where it really makes a difference if it's fresh. And then you combine them. The beauty of an oil cake like this is you don't have to worry about creaming the butter, or you just mix everything together. It goes so quickly. And what I'm looking for is I want the flour to be just incorporated. A few little lumps are okay, but you don't want any little white patches because those white patches will stay there when you bake the cake, and then you will slice up the cake and there'll be a little white patch. See, I told you this was the ugliest batter in the whole world. It is an ugly batter. It is a delicious cake, I promise. So right here I've got a greased and floured, very heavyweight bundt pan. Now it's really important to use a heavyweight bundt pan because I find that the flimsy ones tend to have the batter stick. And then when you try to unmold your beautiful cake, instead of a beautiful bundt cake, you get a mess. This rises quite a bit, so it's not gonna fill it all the way up. And then just leave a little bit right around the sides for your small child to lick. That should do her. It bakes at 350 for about an hour-ish. Now I'm gonna do something else that my grandmother never would have done. I'm gonna serve the honey cake with a little bit of macerated plums. I got some gorgeous plums at the farmer's market, all different colors, and I'm going to add a little bit of honey to sweeten it up and some lemon thyme. I've got some lemon thyme leaves right here. So I'm just gonna bruise them up. By the way, this is the best aromatherapy in the world. It smells so good. Throw that in. If you can't get lemon thyme, you can use regular thyme. It's gonna be good too. This needs to sit for about 30 minutes, just so all the flavors can come together. See, for a pretty ugly batter, it made a good looking cake. If you want, you can do powdered sugar on the top, but I just think that this dark brown color is so pretty, I'm gonna leave it. Definitely a different take on Rosh Hashanah honey cake, but I think it's one my grandmother would have really liked. Mmm, or actually loved.